It is Marathon Sunday. Tens of thousands of people from all over the world are competing in the iconic New York City Marathon.
And on a nice weekend for it, too. They start on Staten Island for a 26.2-mile course that takes them through all five boroughs. CBS 2's Zinnia Maldonado, she joins us now live at the starting line, Fort Wadsworth.
Good morning. Yes, there is only about a short amount of time where we're going to see the first wave of runners making their way out here, of course, starting at the Verrazano Bridge and then ending up over at Central Park and West Drive. There's a lot of energy out here, excitement, of course, mixed with a little bit of nerves. Now, I want to introduce, we have a runner here, Anthony Tucker. Anthony, talk to us about your passion for running. You have an amazing story about how you got into running. So tell us about that and also a little bit about yourself. You're from the Bronx, so share that.
Actually, I'm from Harlem, 112th Street. I live in the Bronx now, and I work in the Bronx as well. Running wasn't always something that I thought that I could do as a leisure sport or, you know, physical activity. But in 2020, we know the state of the world was in shock when a lot of things happened. But for me, it was a triggering moment where trauma came back and resurfaced. And I discovered running to kind of ease those frustrations and angered feelings that I had pent up inside of me in order for me to kind of make sense of the world and process things a little bit better. And I just stumbled upon running, and what do I know that this thing has been a treat and a joy for me. I would say, I always say, is that like my life has been like a marathon, but without the things that make it manageable, like the training, the coaching, the liquid, the fuel, all of those things. You know, imagine you going through life without having that type of support, right?
That's a great metaphor. And then also, talk to us, this is your first New York Marathon, right?
My first New York Marathon. It's exciting. I'm really excited to be out there and feel the energy from the crowd and all of my family and friends who are supporting me. I grew up in New York, East Harlem, and it comes through our neighborhood two times, First Avenue and again on Fifth Avenue. And we just never, you know, had it in our minds to be on the other side of that fence and being a part of this amazing atmosphere. And it's just been so out of reach for us. But I'm here to kind of be an example for everybody who feels like, you know, something can't be done because you aren't exposed to it, that it, you know, time, maybe impatience, you know, things will eventually come towards you, and that's what I'm here to represent.
A lot of motivation. So good luck to you today running this marathon. As you, you know, been hearing throughout the morning as we speak to different runners, everyone running for a different cause, a different reason, but definitely still going to have share that same feeling of accomplishment once they get to that finish line. For now, we're live this morning from Fort Wadsworth on Staten Island. Zinnia Maldonado, CBS 2 News.
Zinnia, thank you. Inspiring stories about why they run. And you can expect traffic closures, of course, on the bridges and the road, because the marathon starts at the Verrazano Bridge. That has been shut down. There are also closures at the Pulaski Bridge, Queensboro Bridge, and Madison Avenue Bridge. For a complete list of street closures and the best places to watch the marathon, head to cbsnewyork.com.